one owner car guy, and I'm going to do kind of a walk around of my new lot here that I just put a bunch of stuff on. This 300 CE is a coupe, like a 90, 93 or something like that. Make you a great deal on $29.50 YouTube special. Michelin premises on it. Great, good looking, good running car. 04 Crown Vic, great shape, around 110 on it or so. The Chevy G20, there's a little tear in the interior there, and that's the worst of it anywhere. It's in beautiful shape. Oh, and above the seat there, you can see a tear. This is super cheap. Before I list this rig, I will sell this for, look at this. Brand new Bridgestones on it. This thing's gonna fit up nice. I'll sell it cheap. Let me know if you're interested. 560 SEC, 100 and a quarter on it or so. That's sold. The 400 SE, clean car. I take 2,800 bucks for it. Needs a throttle positioning sensor, or maybe the throttle body tightened up. It's in great shape. Still got the Audi wagon over there. This one's going to Sweden or Switzerland, I'm not sure. Celebrity is sold, a fair amount I still have. Nice car. The Vet 93, if you're interested in that style, it's up there. Look at the interior of this, absolutely beautiful. 40,000, yeah. 40,000 original miles. We have the extended service plan on it. Power options. One owner, 86. Lincoln Town Car, 87. Ram Charger. I got the Peugeot here. The Peugeot is such a beautiful little car. Look at this. Absolutely just beautiful. I gotta show you the wood. And I probably showed this in my videos before. Look at that wood. And there's a review of it on my channel. But the car is just tight. One owner, 92,000 miles. I'll have this coming up soon. It's a 90? 88? Heck, I don't know. I forget. What is this thing? 87. Lincoln's a nice little car. It runs great. Camry, 81 or 86,000 original miles. Maroon interior with the sheepskin covers. Ooh, buddy. All the books there. And then he's got like a service booklet with all the work done. Everything's all in. Oh, man. What a cool car. Let me check. 77,000. Excuse me. 190E. Someone lower this car. It's a one or a two owner though. And it has 68, I think. 8,000 original miles. Interior's beautiful. Yeah, 68. It's hard to keep all these straight, but I try. All the books and records. Very nice driving with a Momo wheel. Got the Chevy G20 van, 90 or 93. Got a 79 450 SL. Another 560 over here. I've got about six or seven 500, 560s, and 420s right now. This is a very nice van. 96,000 original miles. Runs and starts great. This 560, pretty clean car. A few tears in the seats. I'll sell this one really cheap. That's sold, going to the UK. One owner, electronic four-wheel drive, 96, which I believe is the last year model for this car, or truck, or van, or whatever. Got the very nice sportier interior with the rear air and rear radio controls and all that. 42,000 original miles on this car, I believe, on this van. Got a 500 SEL here, really good shape. Nice Eagle GTs. I like good tires. Good tires affects what I buy. CRX, got another one of these in. Been a little while, but I do like them, and I don't know what I'm going to do with it yet. I'll make a deal like it is. It's a one owner. It's got 81,000 original miles. So, oh, and the 81 Civic wagon. I like these rare little classic cars. Even a Honda. That's right. We're not prejudiced here. I go for all that stuff. It just has to fit my... There we go. Look at that. He filled all this up. Pretty cool. The book spine is falling apart. But make a deal on this before I get it listed on eBay. And that's the thing with my channel. Get a hold of me before I get it on eBay. I make you a really good deal. After I get it that far, it costs me a bit more. So call me up about it. Nathan, 406-544-6919. There's Breeder. She knows I'm up top and she watches my every move there. And she's just sitting there watching me work. And watch, when I'm out here in the lot, she'll start running around in circles in there. You can see there's a little wet nose mark all along my... There she comes. You see wet nose mark all in front of her there. Everywhere she goes. Got the 02 Merc Grand Marquis. We're going to start up here. Nice car. Just drove it to Montana and back. So it's got our stuff in it. Got a puppy in it. And... hang on a second. Samantha, I'm just going to do these videos. We need to get the puppies out in here now. I don't know what year this Crown Vic is. We just pulled up and... she's doing a... I sold my trick, my 68 Firebird, darn it. Makes me a little angry. 77,000 on the car, and I believe they're original, but the guy had a dog chew the hell out of a couple things, and the window regulator on that one I think is bad, and, you know, it's just not that clean of a car. And I kind of just ended up with this one. But still, it's so cheap, it's pitiful. So cheap, it's pitiful. So if you're looking for one of these, let me know. One owner... on that. Gotta love them government bought tires. Windstar 98. And this here is a one owner Dodge pickup. Needed a fuel pump and an alarm taken off of it. Like, great BFGs on it. It's in great shape. You get this clear coat fade on these a lot. This one's got it. Four door or something like that. Whatever you want to call it. Seat pops up, lays down, and all that good stuff. Very clean. Let that close on your head, it don't feel too good. 93,000 original miles on this truck. I've been driving it around. 280C. Yeah, baby. Very nice car. Very good running car at one point here. And then we had to try and get it started. We were tinkering with the air cleaner on it, I know, and it's inside, and I don't have a lot of mechanic and help right now. I forget what year this is, 72? I gotta look, darn it. It is a 280C, I'll tell you that much. W114. Maserati bi-turbo. Yeah, baby. I love these little Maserati cars like this. Not the coolest car in the whole world for some, but it's definitely unique. You don't see them anymore. This is an extremely low mile car. 41,000 original miles. It's in great shape. Somebody calling to buy it right now. Little Fiat 2000. And I'm not going to catch that right now. I can't. I'm going to finish this video. This thing, I'm just getting rid of. Somebody wants it, ship it right to you really cheap. It needs restored. I believe the fuel pump on this one was an issue. Got some cobwebbers inside. 5-speed. Nice little car. Be fun to redo. and a fuel pump. Fuel pump and an ignition coil, I believe, is where I got to on this. Don't have a bumper. And this one, heck, I'd take $950 for that car. SD, got a couple bad tires. Very clean inside. 170, I think?
184.
Very clean on the seats and the headliner and all. I love a clean SD, for sure. 90 Fleetwood Flare. That's sold, the D. Saab Sonet, 74 maybe? I don't know, something like that. Gotta love these little Saab Sonets. Cute little four-cylinder in them. Same as the little D4 I've got in my Saab 9.6 at my other yard. 5.0 GLX, very rare car. In the convertible in this year, 83. Okay, one of my favorite cars I have, the big wagons have a 305. This bad boy got a 350.
Look at these rally wheels too. Rally honeycomb-y, I don't know what the hell to call them.
Beautiful, but it's a Le Mans Safari wagon. And you do not see these very much. Got a really cool classic Pontiac front end. Dash is a little cracked. Guy'd need to get a new dash on it, I think, to make it just beautiful. It's still got nice cush to it. They are original miles.
New headliner, and
the seats are tore. Beautiful car. Runs great. Neat car there. Honda Prelude. 85? 6? I don't know. 80 something? 385, so 85. Kind of got the Recaro type seats, 107. Right. Sunroof. The Dodge Dart GT. Did I say Dart? Dodge Dart GT. Grills out because we had a problem with the hood latch. This is a very nice classic car. Check out my website, www.oneownercarguy.com. You see a lot of classic stuff on there. This is a nice car.
I love them. I think that's a factory seat. It's really good.
That is too slick. I want to restore this one. That's why I've kind of not done anything to it. You can see there that it's a Dart GT and all. The only rust is like this surface stuff where the paint's flaked off. But on www.oneownercarguy.com, you can see a lot of my stuff. You can also check out my channel here. I've got almost 650 videos. I got four of these Sevilles like this. They're actually three in the square body and one in the slant back. And it's locked over here. Very nice interior on this one. Vinyl top. A couple little issues on it. Starting. Where that fell off. Being there. It's kind of a project-y. A little piece of trim missing. But non-rusty, non-beat to heck. Nobody's molested this thing. Got the factory wheel. In fact, I could take them wheels for my other one. I got three of them here. I need to make a complete one. A complete one. 85 Suburban. One owner. Nice truck. Runs great. Big block. Big quarter ton, I believe it is. It's a 20. Whatever that is. Nice set of tires on it. This is a great running truck. Now, this one don't look so good with my two beat-up tires on this side. But it's a 67 Jeep Grand Wagoneer or Wagoneer or Cherokee. What is it? Don't know. Wagoneer. That's right. I knew it was a Wagoneer. I just didn't think there was a Grand in front of it on this year. All your wind deflectors, dust deflectors on all the windows. Pretty cool. It's actually pretty clean. It runs great. Nice clean truck. This one too, just like some. I just keep wanting to restore. It's so close to being nice. There's not, no, it's just got the patina on top where
the ding there, wherever the paint goes off. There you go. There's some rust for you.
There's nothing to talk about right home about. It's just a clean truck, for sure. 327 Jeep motor. So, that's that. Little 633 with the oxblood red interior and 67,000 original miles. This is a very nice car. Runs great. Numbers are gone. I can't tell you. I keep wanting to redo this one too. By redo, I mean paint. Very, very clean. If you're looking for one of these, let me know. I make a great deal on this one. And this Cadillac, I got a flat tire. You see a review on my channel. It's a one owner and it's an original model car. Beautiful. Straight as can be. If you're looking for a coupe de ville like this, definitely get in touch with me. I believe it's it's 126 thou. I gotta check my records. I don't believe it's 126,000. I believe it's 26,000. Just the shape it's in. It's one or the other. How's that? Clean as can be. Just a straight car. You'll see a full review of a lot of these on my channel. This wagon you'll see on there. Got the 91 7.3 diesel E350. Yeah, baby. Great condition. 156. Is that right? 186. I could go into Montana to bring something back. Suburban sold. Should have brought a water bottle with me. I'm running out of juice here. That's going to New Zealand. 93 Thunderbird Super Coupe. 42,000 or so miles on it. Yeah, 46. That's right. Very clean car. Head gasket problem. I'll sell this so cheap it's pitiful. The Packard I've actually sold. It's going to East Texas. I got another GTA here. I just got this out of my other storage place. A third one that I closed. I got the branch in there to hold it up. But just a clean, good running 350 vet block GTA here. I love the GTA wheels. 420. You know, it's just not clean enough for what I'm going to do. And so I'm going to be getting rid of it. It's only got 128 on it. But a few splits in the seat. It's the kind of thing that you get on Craigslist for 2,500 bucks or something. Got a bad tranny, actually, this one. I'll take 1,300 bucks. It gets to be the parts for me for that, and then yank everything I can off and scrap it. I hate to do it with a 128,000 mile car that starts up and runs great. Generator on my scan van with the articulating boom, my friend. Not just the regular boom, the articulating boom. Got the power plug-ins and all that. 280 CE, rarer car. 100 and something on it, 130. Seats are clean enough. It's a clean enough car. I think there was some corrosion along the bottom of the doors there. That was the worst thing on this car. It's a tight car. I'd sell this one. You guys want something like that shipped to you? I'd sell this car. Look at here. I got to show you the damage for it. Tell you the price. Right around the light. I believe it was a one owner. Very clean car. Just needs some loving. This one I'd sell for... 1,400 bucks. 67,000 miles on the 90 or 91 Cadillac Seville. It's in great shape. I don't have the keys on them like I do on my other lot. Opel's going to Germany. That's going to Netherlands. I got two Bromes right now. This is a 96, I believe. Which if it is, that'd be the last year model. I believe. I don't really know nothing, do I? In fact, this is an 87. Cutlass Cruiser. And then this one over here is the other kind of Brome. Yeah, they are a little bit different. Nice custom cruiser. Nice 86 Corvette 88 somewhere in our 88, I think. Corvette 350 TPI with the
gaudy wheels.
Yeah,
baby. These were the wheels to have back in the day.
88 Brome with the Elegance, somewhere 86 to 88. Love them big, fat knuckle wire wheels with the gold spoke. I might have showed this one at some point. A couple things I was going to have done to it. A couple fixes on the interior. Beautiful car, 74,000 original miles. The red and the white just look amazing with the gold package.
And I know you probably can't see it as good as usual here.
Bonneville SSEI or whatever. It's SSE or SSEI or SSE. I don't know. It's the supercharged one. How's that? Got some... I don't think they were the factory wheels. They got a nice set of tires on it. The interior, I had that because it's got a leak from the tranny. Speakers are tore apart there. You see it's got some problems and issues, and the headliner's gone. I could fix that headliner for 150, fix the seat for about two. Or I could just sell you this thing also. So cheap and make your head spin. It's got really low miles, and it's a one or two owner, and the hood's up there, but I'd take, I don't know, how about $1,750. Euro model 380 SE. Very, very nice car. Got the really fat BFGs on the Mercedes wire wheels, true spokes. Look at this factory Euro cloth interior. Have you ever seen a factory Euro cloth in that kind of shape? I mean, you just don't see it on this Euro. Especially the light tan like that. I don't remember if I had the books. I got the regulator. Did the wood door panels off because I need the regulators repaired. Yeah, and that's what I do a lot is tinker around and fix windows and stuff like that. And, you know, sometimes I leave it for the customer to do and... depends on the car. That wind is really going. This is an awesome RV. If you're looking for a very clean RV, this is a very clean RV. No foul smells, nothing like that. Don't leak all over. I do not dig the carpet, and I'm thinking about repairing it by just tearing it out and replacing it. the coolest thing about this, it's a one-owner rig. And if you watch my channel much, you know I love a one-owner rig. 33,000 original miles. Mine a lot, I got the keys and stuff. Used to just grabbing it and turn it on. All that stuff up here. And that's the inside of this. 90 or 91? Oh, the Fiero GT, I haven't showed you that. The Magnum sold XE. This Fiero GT is an 86. It is a, it could be an 87. It's a very clean car, low mile. It is a GT model, 1086, so it's an 87. See, I think in terms of that, of taking it to the Netherlands and such, 86 and older is okay to take. And an 87 like this, I believe, works just fine. As long as it was made in 86. Got the club, one owner, 100,000 on the nose, 100,730. That guy must have just thought he had just had to get rid of it once it hit 100. This and the little grills there, they blew off on the transport on the way down. Toolbox, custom cab, Ford pickup truck. Camper special, baby. You see a little bit of, maybe you know what motor this is by looking. I don't. Big block. Oh, I don't want to start that issue. Whether it's a big block or small block. 280P, regular gasser car in the 123 body. Super clean interior. And the way this is just really, really, really different. I don't know, they're not as tight as the other ones. It's a different pattern. 129 on it. Absolutely hardly no miles for one of these. Love this custom cab. you know, I'm gonna run out of time on this deal. And no, I. That truck sold. This wagon, if you want a 300 diesel wagon, this is the one to have. It'll buff out nicely. It's an 80. Check this out. Ding. Nice set of Indy Firehawk Firestone tires. I mean, they are just got all kinds of tread. Look at that. Look like it. So much titties on the side, like a titty bar. And that's all of them. I think they might have been a mismatched set though, but they're all good tires. A couple tears and such. Needs an injector pump. And they brushed into it at the auction, as you can see right there. Just barely. You put your trim back on, you'd hardly notice it. And this piece of rubber trim is fitting off there. Other than that, it's ran a TD. That's the worst of the corrosion on it. Around there, a couple places. I take YouTube special here. Oh heck. Starts up, runs, drives, shifts. Just blows smoke everywhere. You can't drive it nowhere. It needs an injector pump. My other guy said it might just be injectors. I'm taking worst case scenario. Oh yeah, there was that corrosion there. Right there where they get it. $1,600. What a deal! One owner, 100, 120,000 miles, $2,000. Before I do anything else to it. I'm gonna have to do this video in two parts. I've almost burned up 29 minutes. Very clean, 80,000 original miles. Headliner sag a little bit there. This is a very clean Landau top caddy. 79? All of them do that. All of them. Super clean except for that. This is what you're looking for. Look no farther. I got two of them. The yellow one over there and this one. Got the other square Seville back there. Got the gate open here. I actually ran out of film the other day. I'll show you up close of this one. You can see that the paint's all checked on it. It's coming off, but solid car, aside from the obvious. And the only real rust room is right there, the water collected. It's actually really clean on the body, but as you see, it's going to need completely redone. The wood is fake wood, it's really nice on it. Like I say, I bought it for the bows and everything, and parts and the running motor. This truck is very clean. It's gonna buff out nice, but we got this starting right on the drift arrow. I don't know why, except for that before we got it, there was pine needles right here, and I think it just kind of collected the water, but then you got this issue. And I did look around, it's a clean truck. Runs really good. I don't have the keys in it. It's got all kinds of records and books and stuff with it. 68 or 72,000 original miles. It's been sitting for a few years, got nice meats on it, a little bit of dry rot, but if you want a good, cheap Ford, this is it. You can see the metal on it. I'll show you here. See that? Right along there. And then the frame is just clean, but wherever the undercoating came off, it's just a little corroded. Frame's all good, but stuff like that, it's not as good on the around the mufflers, then we'll go at some point. Clean truck, not all rusted to hell, but there is some corrosion on some key areas. And nice truck, that's sold. It's 300E, about nice as it gets. Very nice on the interior. Headliner and all. I might have shown this one in another video. It's only a 115,599. It's getting ready to turn right to 116 right now. Or 590. It's 10 miles away. This is my landlord's. He was repoed it. We need to make sure the bottom is unlocked and lights are on. Yeah, it's getting them lined out to have that open. But this thing, I'll show you the inside. It's got a nice generator in it. I'm going to put it on eBay for a bit more. But, heck, $1,200 and it's gone.
I wouldn't go driving it to Florida. Just dry rot on the tires and such. Nice awning. All the amenities inside. Might as well show it to you real quick here. I had to get the battery going here. We just drove it over to my other lot. Yeah, it is in nice shape. There's a leak back here and a leak in here. I was going to put that liquid roof thing on it. That's amazing. 51,000 and their original miles. Just neat for the desert or something. Hasn't been cleaned or detailed or nothing. But good runner. One owner Dodge. And the clear coat's gone on it. You'll see it in the videos in certain spots. But this one's coming up next. One owner, 93,000 original miles. I'd actually been driving this one around a bit. It's a nice truck. Runs good. That one's going to New Zealand. Don't know what that one, Caddy, deal is with it yet. Beautiful LTD Crown Victoria wagon. It's in great shape. It's a one owner car. And this one's set here for a week because my guy dropped the keys down the vent and we can't get them out. And it's in beautiful shape. And they went right down there. So, you don't know. No startup on this one for now. And I actually had a few wagons, so I made sure full set of wheels on this one. It is a one owner. I got extra hubcaps there. But this wagon is a very nice wagon. If you're interested in a Crown Vic, geez, I don't know what to call these. See, I don't got the stickers on the back. I know it's an LTD Crown Victoria because of the obvious. I know the Mercs were a Colony Park. I got one of them coming in. It's a Woody. 90? I got about 4 or 5. I got about 15 wagons right now. But, okay, well, it's a quick walk around in there. New Zealand and Australia, I forget. This one, of course, your regular stuff is going on it. Somebody put the expensive sheepskins in it. It's in good shape. Starts, drives, all that. I love the thermometers on these that go up to 120. If he gets to go to 120, it's Mad Max days, man. This is a one owner car. Cops going on it. Cheap. You're getting back into the kind of stuff I had to take out of that other yard there. It's not going to be your perfect stuff. But I am taking a video of everything here to where you can see what's on this lot. This is a nice trailer. This was top of the line. Stuff. What is it, 89, 86? Don't remember. We use it for security and stay. All your books. Real porcelain sinks. No fridge. So you don't have to worry about whether it works or not. Got the bathtub, which is pretty, pretty slick. With the full, a lot of room. A lot of room to get ready. So it's pretty nice. Security trailer for now. Yule trailer very soon. Call me if you're interested. I'll have to check on the year. It's mid-8. And it's in great shape. And it was top of the line then. And it's still very, very old. Your LPG. Here we go. 88. I'm thinking 88. Makes sense. We'll go with that for now. It's all plugged in and stuff because it's a working unit. Oh, it's insulated. Back of the fridge is not there. He's got everything going in it. And there was a seal I had to fix on it there, and a window those out.
Okay, that is most of the stuff. The scan van there only has 73,000 miles, articulating boom. I showed you a lot of this yesterday. I stepped on that, I thought it was a dead pigeon at first. I'm like, ugh! Okay, next. I showed you all this stuff, I showed you up top. I kind of didn't get over this way. Got this Regal 50,000 original mile car. Haven't even touched it yet. Very clean.
That's a good on it. Pity too.
Clean coupe. Cheap. Haven't touched it. Kind of sputters. Got some kind of intake problem or something. Got this military Cuckby. Someone thought they were a wicked genius and they would make it into a single battery 12 volt setup instead of the dual 24. It's a new one of them in the back. It's a clean rig. It's not all rusty or nothing. Somebody put some paint on it. It's not camo at some point. It is a 6.2 liter M1008 or M1009. I don't remember what these were. It's one or the other. Got the Danas. Are they the big Dana 44s? The Dana this? The Dana that? I don't Dana know. It's that axle in the front. I don't think it's the huge, huge ones. Simply because these are a 3/4 ton Blazer, I believe, rated over. And the trucks are a ton and a quarter. Or something to that effect. So whatever axles that are. That are? That ain't the way it's said. This truck, I'll get rid of so cheap it's pitiful. Total project. Nice tires with a little bit of dry rot on the sides. Mudder, I don't know whatter, but part of the dash is gone. The 46 on it is supposed to be, I don't know. He's got that in there. The gauges, never redid the U.S. Army dash there. Different seats, I know. It's a nice little rig. Big, a nice project, nice hunting truck. Got the gun racks in it still there. I believe that's what that was. This one is a... Hold on. Wow. 86, I think. Yeah, 786. Pretty cool. Got an extra military thing on it. There you go. Cuckby Utility M1009 shipping data plate. There you go. Axle loads. Total 52, 64 max. Cool. Then 70 69, I don't remember. W108 though, I know that. 71, that's wrong on both counts. Wood's all peeled up. 91,000 miles on it. Supposed to be original with the floor shift. Yes, it's a little dirty. Yes, it is an imperfect shape. I always need parts. It's so nice on the opening and closing. And yeah, it's not perfect, but it's a 280 SE, and it's cheap. I want to get rid of this. I got to let you know, if you've been watching my channel for a while, and you're just looking for a project, this one's a cool car, by the way. That one, the E there, this one, and this here, I'm moving them. I'm moving them to get rid of them. Now, this is a two-owner car. I got to show you under the hood. You see the broken light there. And it's set at my place, got some leaves on it. Two-owner, all maintained. Look at that. Wait till you see this thing when I wash it. It's just a beautiful car. There's a tear in the seat right there. Other than that, this thing is beautiful. And all your books, look at this. Filled out right up to next service due, 127. It's at 132 there. That's the lubrication service. He ran out of papers. He did. He totally used the entire book up. The book is gone. The book has all the little stamps here from all Hohen Motors, Mercedes-Benz, and Anton Motors, and something Otto has. Not only did he use up the whole book there, he used up all of his brake checks. Replaced brake fluid. Look at this. This car has been meticulously replaced coolant. There's four times right on that page. This car has been meticulously maintained. and it's a one owner. There's a 127 right there, so he actually did that one. The next service would be due after that. It says actually February 1407. I've had this for 2.5 years, and I just haven't done anything with it. It's a beautiful car. If you're looking for a 420 like this, it's one of the nicest ones you'll find. Oh, young timer right here. Nice export to Netherlands. I gotta double check that. I'm 99.9% sure. Yes, sir. 2 of 86 on a W126. So this is a perfectly maintained one owner that is ready to go to Netherlands. Look at there. Yeah, there. Oh, my guy was testing the antenna. I'll bet you the antenna's in op. And that's the kind of stuff I fix or look at on them. Look at the Pirelli Scorpions on this truck. I like good tires here. I've showed you up top. Go down below. Show you what's in the bottom. I hadn't been down here in a little while. But I now got three out front here. Yeah, the BMW 735. This is a beautiful one owner BMW. I don't do a lot of the 6 and 7 series BMWs, but this one was so nice and so clean. It's got all the selectors and stuff. It's got the actual... I wish I could let you see just how amazing that the wood is in this car. Actually, it's better than... It's just different than a Mercedes. I mean, it looks like Geppetto made it or something. 75,000 original miles on this black beauty here. Beautiful car. I got all the books and everything. I'm a freak for books, tires, and one and two owners. Yeah. Hit all that stuff on the bat, on the nose there. And I'm in love with this. And I'm not prejudiced. BMW, Mercedes-Benz. Heck, we just did a Lexus. The guy was happy as could be. And I love selling what somebody's looking for. He was looking for the LS400 99. What he wanted. I wish I could have a Lorenzo package S600 in a 99. Books in this one. This is a nice car. It's 127 on it. One owner. All vinyl and everything. Interior might be leather. I don't know. But it leaks through the headliner right here. Right there, huh? So... That is that, a couple spots. It's just almost toasted the car. I mean, it's not really all that. It's an LTD Crown Victoria. It's 5.0, it's a nice car. Still so cheap, it's pitiful. I'm gonna actually steal parts maybe at some point. All the wood on the trim is starting to go on this car. Don't know what we'll do on that. It's got a dent in the front and stuff. 84,000 original miles. Good clean van. It's a Dodge Caravan with the Brome Woody. Dave, the FedEx guy. Must be that. Got a FedEx at my office. Now, I don't know how long this video is going to be. The other one was like 25 minutes. Oh, yeah. I forgot I had this. The Mercury Cougar. This is a nice car. Actually, might not have it long. My buddy asked me about a cheap $2,500 car or so. And that's about what I'm at on this one. Absolutely beautiful car. Here's my plate I've been looking for. Mm-hmm. People leaving stuff in cars. I want to use this part for something totally different, but I just haven't yet. The Buick Electra T-Type, nice car. I've got a review of that. If you want a beautiful truck, this Bravada is an awesome truck. And this is just a quick walk around of the lot. If you've been watching the videos of moving it in and all, this is kind of an update. www.oneownercarguy.com. Check out all my stuff on there, and I got my center cap. Now, is that stupid or what? This car has sat around for an extra month and a half while I dicked around and got some little... They go right there. And I refused to pay some big money for them, and I got them on bid on the internet there. And just, I like them. And I, there was one on here, and I think, I have to get wheels done sometimes. I mean, this one was on here. Look at that wheel. Just looks amazingly beautiful. And that one bugged me so much with that one. So we'll go from this to that. And I just love that centerpiece, and it makes it look so much beefier. This is a one owner Cutlass Supreme. It's in great shape. One of the last years of this body style. I don't even know what year it is. 85. It was 87 the last year? I don't know. 75 thou on it. And it's the Supreme model. Got his club and his windshield back here. I want to use this for something totally different though. I wanted to have a YouTube video room, but just never had that exact thing going. I got too much to do. Too much things going on. I'm using it for storage. It's kind of ridiculous. Show you the next one here. It's a neat Plymouth Caravan. I'm gonna go in down here. There's four bays here. Four bays? Yeah, four bays. Eight spots. And in those eight spots. If you want this, my buddy's gonna be selling it. Nice little Blazer. And it's a full, it's been redone. It's the full, it has the top and all. It's the actual deal. And it's been sitting, getting dust and such, but we're talking, and he's got the right tranny and everything. Oh man, this is a nice little, and it's just dusty. It's been sitting for a long time. Bluebird tailgate. 560 SEL. This is a low mile one. I've actually got a lot of these coming in. And in. This one's got 91 on it. And I was looking at fixing that window regulator. Nice car. Mustang GT over here in purple with the Roush kit on it. Roush, however you want to say it. I'll show you the side pipe kit. Roush. That's how I say it, I guess. I don't know if it did underdrive pulleys or anything on it. You know, these Mustangs are fun with the light ass end and all. I do dig them. Can you dig it? I can dig it. The Roush side pipe system. This thing sounds mean. And a couple little things on it. And my guy is amazing on seats. What's this got on it? 117 automatic. Digging the purple. Right there, I don't know what I'm gonna do to it yet. It's got the full body spoiler kit. It is dusty as heck too. Yeah, I don't know what's kinda, I mean, factory, definitely. OW wheels. What size are they? I don't know. Pilot. They were Michelin Pilots. Are they? 245/40ZR17. And they are Michelin Pilots. Wow. That's nice. This truck's nice. Nathan, 406-544-6919. I need my lift right there. Yes, sir. I'm going to show you up in the showroom. Oh, that looked kind of cool, didn't it? Sure did. Just a little bit of light. Have to get them to lock up down here. Okay, here we go for the final little leg of it. Like I say, any of the stuff you see on here, I will make you a smoking deal on. I got a black Porsche coming that I just picked up. 87, I believe. The Angelina Jolie Jaguar. The puppies. I have two puppies left. Hi guys. Hi guys and girls. Hi breeder. How you doing, baby? Are you taking care of your babies? Yes, you are, huh? Yeah. I'm okay. Bye bye. I'll be right back. They're so cute. Make you a smoking deal on that Crown Vic, on the Windstar, on the Mercedes Coupe. You name it. As far as the stuff goes. You've seen the Citroen. And you've also seen the Paraglider. DS21 Citroen. I love the look of the front and the back. Honda Passport I did a review on. My Firebird, unfortunately, is sold. But what's this? Yes, sir. Make you a smoking deal. Have a review of this coming up pretty soon. 68 Corvette. Convertible. All the options. Awesome car. 4-speed. Convertible. Batteries are the worst thing around here. Yes, actually. Speakers and stuff, it is the only thing not really factory. Carbon monoxide ourselves out of here. Here's some loud inside. I kind of like that. So, that'll be coming up really soon. Nice in and out. Got the subs behind the seat and all. All custom.
All original, easy to pull that stuff out.
I'll have a review of this up in a week or so. I don't know. I can't really do them in here, I think. I don't get the look of the... I don't know, maybe I do. I'll do this as a test. Run out of time there, too. www.oneownercarguy.com. You can reach me anytime on there by looking at my inventory. Lots of it's on there. I'm way behind on getting it all up, but you know, the stuff that's ready to go is on there. And this might not make a bad place to pull it in the center. If I could get all my lights working at the same time, it'd be good. I can't really seem to figure them out. Nathan, 406-544-6919. And as you see, I'm pulling stuff out of my personal storage and everything. And selling stuff I don't really want to sell all that bad. That's a very nice driving car. And you'll see lots of cool stuff coming up. Thanks for watching. Have a great day or night, whatever it is. Wherever you are, don't know what kind of length I'm going to have on this video, but it's been fun doing it. So give me a call with any questions. Nathan, 406-544-6919, www.oneownercarguy.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day or night, whatever it is, wherever you are. Remember, if I have, I got all the amps, subs, and decks and everything like that you could ever want. Thanks for watching. Have a great day or night. We'll talk to you.